forward and reverse bias of PN junction diode. When the positive terminal of a cell is connected to P side and negative terminal is connected to N side, it is called forward bias. In the junction region, there is depletion region and an electric field from N to P side in an unbiased PN junction diode. Now this impressed polarity of the cell induces an electric field in reverse direction which opposes the original electric field of the depletion region. This new electric field will push the diffusion current by injecting holes to the N side and moving free electrons to the P side. The voltage in forward bias increases diffusion current, whereas the drift current which were due to formation of holes and free electrons in the depletion region gets suppressed because the impressed electric field will not let them go to the P side, that is, will not allow the holes to go into P side or free electrons to go into N side, which constituted drift current. The drift current therefore gets suppressed and diffusion current is enhanced, which you can see here in the characteristic curve that when the impressed voltage is small, there is very small current, but as soon as this voltage becomes comparable to the barrier potential, suddenly the current in forward bias shoots up to the order of milliampere. This voltage is known as knee voltage and is nearly 0.6 volt as barrier potential voltage for silicon is 0.7 volt. In reverse bias, the positive terminal of the cell is connected to N side and negative terminal of the cell is connected to P side. This aids the original electric field of the unbiased PN junction diode and therefore the width of depletion region now increases. It remains of order of micrometer, but it increases, making it difficult for holes and free electrons to diffuse to other side and therefore the diffusion current gets suppressed. Whereas when the bonds are broken in the depletion region, this impressed electric field further aids their drift, that is, send the holes to P side and free electrons to N side, increasing the drift current. That is, the drift current which was from N side to P side increases, whereas diffusion current gets suppressed here. But the drift current depends on formation of holes and free electrons in the depletion region, and since depletion region is very narrow, so not sufficient number of holes and free electrons are generated. Therefore, value of drift current remains low, and as you can see here in the characteristic curve that it remains of order of microampere. The value of current remains low, but as the voltage is increased in reverse biasing to a certain value, say 5.6 volt for most of the semiconductors, then the electric field creates a strain in the bond and large number of holes and free electrons are suddenly generated, which we call as Zener breakdown. So due to Zener breakdown, suddenly the current in reverse biasing increases and the diode starts conducting beyond Zener breakdown. But under normal conditions, the reverse bias current remains very small, and hence we say that in reverse bias, semiconductor does not conduct, whereas in forward bias, it conducts, making it similar to a valve which lets the flow of current in one direction and opposes the flow of current from other direction. Thank you.